Hey everybody, welcome to Kitchen Cut-Ups with Kyle. Today I've got a little bit of help in the kitchen. My little sister Carrie Jo's came over to help me out, and my daughter Madeline's in here, she's gonna help out too. We're gonna make cinnamon candy. Savannah's back there operating the camera for me, so this should be pretty interesting. Now,
yeah, I know, kind of.
Always landscape. We gotta do this right. We gotta be professional about this. Get out of here, Nat. Anyway.
Usually they don't have it land.
So cinnamon candy is something that my mom used to make all the time, and everybody loved her cinnamon candy. And so I cannot find the recipe, so I got this one off online, and I kind of added some stuff and made it my own. So the first thing that it calls for is to get a big pan. I've got a big cookie sheet here, and I put aluminum foil over it. And I didn't think it was gonna work, but it worked perfectly last night when I made it, so we tried it again. And a little kitchen hack for you, it says to put butter on the pan. I don't have a sprayer yet, so my friend Chris Gordon's supposed to be getting me a butter sprayer here after the first of the year, so shout out to Chris real quick for that. I just used a stick of butter, and I just rubbed it on the pan.
Get some of that butter action.
We're getting the butter action going.
Cool.
So, rubbed a little butter on the pan. That's the first thing you do. So you have your pan all ready to go. So, one other quick shout out too. I got to shout out to Billy Vanilli and his wife Rachel for getting me the awesome apron and the chef's hat that don't fit me. So maybe I can get one of the kids to wear it later or something. So now I'm going to get Savannah, the camera lady, to come over this way. So here's what we're going to show you. Here's the sugar. This is 3 3/4 cups of sugar. So we're going to add a cup of water to it. So we're going to add 1 1/4 cups of light corn oil or corn syrup to this. So this one's almost empty, so let me. And we're going to make a big mess. This stuff gets really hot, so be careful with it. Please do not burn yourself with us when it gets going. So, will you hand me a scraper? One of them scrapers? No, a scraper. I called that butter thing a kitchen hack earlier, and I don't like calling them kitchen anything a hack because that's a bad thing for a comedian to be called. So, we're going to call it a kitchen, I don't know, shortcut. I don't want to be known as a hack. So, 1 1/4 cup.
What?
If you like corn oil or corn syrup.
Corn oil.
And somebody's going to put oil in this thing and really screw it up. He said oil. No, it's corn syrup, ladies and gentlemen. Corn syrup. Light corn syrup.
You could always cut it out, too.
Yeah, I could always cut it out, but that's not the fun part about it.
Yeah, it is.
The reality part.
No, it's making a professional video.
I don't make professional videos. My name is Kyle Kubiak.
Obviously.
So, we got all of that in there.
Comedy what?
He's a comedy man.
Yeah.
So, and then you're going to add 1 teaspoon of red food coloring. You can use green, you can use whatever color you want to, whatever color works for you.
Well, dang, you're getting it everywhere.
I know. I get stuff everywhere because I shake too bad. This is like cooking with Michael J. Fox. Mm-hmm. So, we got all that in there. We're going to turn the oven. I've got an electric oven, so we're going to turn it to 7, okay? So we're going to turn it to 7, which is about a medium-high heat. And we're going to bring that to a boil. So first, I'm going to stir it up here. It's going to be a little hard to stir it first until it starts really cooking. So we're gonna bring it to a boil. Okay, so it's starting to boil. We're gonna let it boil really good here. Let it get to a good, nice, rolling boil. Anyway, so we're gonna get this boil into a rapid boil here. And like I said earlier, one more time on the ingredients. 3 3/4 cups of sugar. And use cheap sugar, it doesn't have to be cane sugar, it could be any kind of sugar. 1 1/4 cup of light corn syrup. The Griffin's works just fine. 1 cup of water and about a teaspoon of red coloring dye. So we've got this boiling pretty good here. I'm gonna stir it once more. And then what we're gonna do.
How long does it usually take to boil?
It's gonna take a while to boil, but the first step in this, because there's several processes to this. This is a very involved cooking deal. It's very hot liquid, so you don't wanna burn yourself. It takes a while to cook and you've gotta manage it. So right now it's at this boil. We're gonna put a lid on it for 3 minutes.
Three.
So I'm looking at my microwave time here. So it's 5:50. So at 5:51, I'm gonna put the lid on it and we're gonna let it boil for 3 minutes with the lid on it. Because that way it breaks down all the sugar crystals. So. You gotta make sure you get the sugar crystals broke down. My daughter's filming all the ingredients. And you'll use about a teaspoon of the cinnamon oil. You can add a little bit more if you want it a little bit hotter. Okay, it's 51 after, we're putting the lid on it. Now we're gonna let this set for 3 minutes with the lid on. And we're letting this boil, stirring occasionally, with the lid on it for 3 minutes. Break down all the sugar. So it's been 3 minutes, we're taking the lid off, and here's the candy. I'm gonna stir it once, and then I'm just gonna leave it. You're gonna leave it for about 10 to 15 minutes and just let it cook, okay? Some people say stir it. I didn't stir it the last time and it seemed to turn out pretty good. So just let it sit there and boil. And have your like a medium high heat, which I've got mine on 7 here. If you got a gas, I don't know what setting it'd be. It's medium hot. So we're gonna let this boil for about 10 minutes and then we're gonna do the drop test since I don't have a candy thermometer. Never owned one, never had one, so we do the drop test in just some cool water, which you just use some just tap water will work just fine for it. Okay, so on me. Never done this with the cameraman. Always had the tripod over there and we'll use it in a little bit. But we're gonna do the drop test right now. So right now I'm just gonna get a regular spoon. I'm gonna get a little bit of this on the spoon. And then I'm gonna just drop it into the cold water. Okay? And it's not supposed to be stringy, so it's still not quite ready. Can already tell. Reach into the water. And you pull out your candy. And it's still a little... It's still a little stringy, so we're gonna let it cook for about another 5 minutes here. But it's almost there. You wanna be able to squeeze it into a little ball. So we're gonna let it cook for a couple more minutes. And let it boil. Still not stirring it. I haven't stirred it this whole time. Some people will tell you to stir it. Others don't. Please do not drop my camera in the hot liquid. So you want to make sure that your candy is hard. Since you don't, I don't have a candy thermometer, like I said earlier. You can buy one, they're probably pretty cheap, but I'm too cheap to buy one. So your temperature for your candy thermometer should be 300 to 310 degrees is what you want on a candy thermometer. The drop test is, several people have told me to do it that way, and especially got a lot of good advice from my wonderful mother-in-law last night was helping me and Stacy with the drop test last night. So, and as you can see, you're gonna make a mess, okay? Make sure that you have everything cleaned up. This makes a pretty big batch. We made about 15 snack baggies last night. Is that correct, Savannah?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, in a snack baggie full is about this. know if you can see that there. That's the product from last night, already done. But you make about 15 baggies, and that's a pretty good amount for one batch. You don't want to double your batch because you can really mess it up. So just do one batch at a time. It does take, you know, a couple of hours to get it all done because it's going to take 45 minutes for it to set in the pan and cool off before you want to start cracking it and everything. So it's got to be completely cool. And that's when you add your powdered sugar, which I didn't mention. You will need powdered sugar too. Confection sugar. And my wife just came home, so that's why the dogs went crazy. So, hi, honey. We're shooting a video for. You want to make sure it goes all the way down to the bottom. Do not touch the hot stuff. Okay, you can probably see here, it's breaking pretty good. So it's just about done. So we're good.
It was a bit, okay.
So the next step is you're gonna take it off the deal. So very carefully remove it from the fire. The dogs are going crazy.
Yep.
Mommy came home. And we're gonna add a teaspoonful of cinnamon oil. You can buy this, this is the most expensive thing that you're gonna get. It's probably cost about 10, 11 bucks, sometimes 15, depending. So 1 teaspoon of that. And we're gonna whisk that in real good. Don't put your face over the pan while you're whisking.
Nope.
Because that cinnamon oil is very, very
strong.
I mean,
he can't even stand by
wow.
it.
Wow. I just sucked in a whole bunch of cinnamon and I'm feeling the effects real quick. So make sure you whisk it good because you don't want your cinnamon to be just in one spot. She turned on the fan, so it's going to be a little loud, but we got to get that cinnamon smell, man. Keep a fan going. Trust me.
Open a few
so
doors.
So we whisked it. We're good to go. And we're going to pour it in the pan. I wish I had Maddie here right now so I could get a scraper. Now Savannah's gonna come over. She handed the camera over to Carrie, so I'm gonna give Carrie credit on the filming too. So she's gonna scrape it. Like I said, be super careful with this. This will burn your skin right off of you.
Thanks.
Yeah.
And I know that all of y'all have probably messed with bonfires that are watching this, and you know how like hot plastic, this is basically what it is. It's just like hot plastic. So we're gonna get this as much as we can scraped out of here. We put it on our pan, which was already covered with butter. Okay, put some aluminum foil over your pan and then cover it with butter. Oh, it's recording, okay. I don't know what happened there. We'll fix this all in editing. But so we're gonna do a time lapse now. For about 45 minutes, we're gonna let this candy set. Make sure you put your lid back on your cinnamon oil, put it away. Turn on your vent to your fan so you can get the cinnamon smell out of the house because it's going to be pretty bad and it'll choke you up. So we're going to time lapse this for 45 minutes and y'all get to watch me. It'll be fast forwarded so you'll get to watch me cook family dinner tonight. I'm cooking spaghetti in the background, but it'll be real quick when we do it. So we'll come back in about 45 minutes and we'll crack this stuff up, put some powdered sugar on it, and it'll be good to go. it's been about 40 minutes. The candy has pretty much cooled. It's not sticky at all. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna get the confection sugar, powdered sugar, whatever you wanna call it. I'm gonna get that out, have it ready to go. Now, easily, should be pretty easy, take your aluminum foil off of your pan. See? Your aluminum foil with the candy still on it. And if you look really closely, you can see that I can pull the foil right off of it. It's coming right off of there, so it's perfect. So, I'll set the candy to the side, and get a little bit of the powdered sugar, and sprinkle it around the pan here. Kind of rub it in there. Now I pulled this off a little early because I'm trying to finish this up so that everybody can watch TV and stuff because it's getting late and I know they're probably like, oh, I don't want to hear any more about this stupid video. Am I right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Yeah, but you know this may...
We're not the bad guys.
This may make us money one day, kids.
Nope.
Dad may be rich because I'm a famous chef on some show.
Nope.
I may be on the Food Network. So...
The
Redneck Food Network.
I believe in the whole dream.
Cooking with possums. Cooking with possums. So, I am pulling off the aluminum foil. And like I said, I pulled it off a little early because crunched for time because the family's crappy. So, look at this beautiful ring of candy here. It's a beautiful ring of candy.
Boy!
Ring of fire. So, hey. So I've got it on the deal. Now, one tip, you can use whatever you want to break it up with, but do not put the confection sugar on top until after you break it, because then you'll have sugar flying everywhere. And I'm the one that has to clean the house, so it's not gonna happen. So you just get them. I got my knife sharpener here. Crack, crack, crack. Crack that sucker. Oh, y'all can comment. I don't care. Nobody else cares either. So I've got this pretty much packed up the way I want it. Probably crack it up a little bit smaller, a little bit lighter. Okay, so now that it's cracked up, get a little bit more of your confection sugar, pour over the top of it, sprinkle it over the top of it. Make sure your hands are not wet when you're messing with powdered sugar. And we're gonna pull up a few pieces for you. And get to the right camera side here. And there you go. There's your cinnamon, hard cinnamon candy. Mmm. Man, that's good. That's good stuff. So, thank you all for watching Kitchen Cut-Ups with Kyle again. Thanks to my family for helping out. Thanks for Billy for the awesome apron. So, I'm going to finish dinner and get the heck out of here. And my daughter's still in candy. We'll see you next time on Kitchen Cut-Ups with Kyle Kubiak. Peace out, people.
Peace out.
Can you come push stop?
Can you add that at the end of your video, please?